Kambalda, Western Australia. Australia's first planned town and a major nickel producer. Kambalda is located 130 kilometres north of Norseman and 55 kilometres south of Kalgoorlie. It's a long drive from Perth, 616 kilometres. Kambalda is a mining town which is divided into two very different sections. Kambalda East, built 1967 to 1973, and Kambalda West, built 1969 to 1975. Settlement dates back to when Percy Larkin, an early prospector, found gold in the late 1800s. The Red Hill gold mine was opened and lasted from 1897 to 1907. After that, the small settlement became a ghost town. Modern interest came from George Kelsill, who took samples of what he thought was uranium in 1954. Subsequent analysis found significant deposits of nickel. And by 1966, the Western Mining Company had established Australia's first nickel mine. Details and pictures of the early gold mining appear in the upper left-hand window. A look at the underground mining of nickel and its concentration into nickel concentrate for shipment to the Kalgoorlie smelter is shown in the upper right-hand window. In the bottom left-hand window, I look at the actual development of the town today and its demise in 2008 due to the collapse in price of nickel. Current date, Kambalda's Woolworths is up for lease and the shopping center is up for sale. Houses are going cheaply, as cheap as $100,000. With the fluctuating price of nickel, Western Mining Company in 2004 sold its mines to Broken Hill Proprietary Limited. Today, they haul their concentrate from Kambalda to the smelter in Kalgoorlie. From here, it's taken for refinery in Kwinana. In the upper left-hand window, we now look at the modern gold mining boom that's occurring. Many of the unemployed miners have moved over into gold mining. There are a number of active gold mines in the Kambalda area and on the road from Kambalda to Kalgoorlie. The bottom left-hand window now looks at recreation in Kambalda. There's not a lot to do, but the tourists find the large saltwater lake, Lake Lefroy, interesting. During the summer, it's used for land sailboating. These crafts can get up to enormous speeds. In the winter, there may be some salt water on the lake, and it becomes too boggy for use. BHP and other companies are conducting active surveys under the lake for nickel. Recently, a number of large new nickel deposits have been discovered, and the future of nickel mining in Kambalda still appears to be bright in spite of fluctuating prices. Thanks for joining me on this brief tour of Kambalda, its history, and its mining industry. I do hope you have a very pleasant day.